Hello, happy site owners and webmasters. I'm Mayanna with Bloggate, and in this video, we'll take a tour of the new features and changes in WordPress 5.9, including Gutenberg updates, as well as full site editing features and tips for designers. So let's dive in. Let's start with the Gutenberg updates. First, we have improvements to the headings block. When you insert a heading block, it defaults to the H2 size, but now, when you want to change to another size, you can click on that H2 and you'll see a vertical drop-down menu of the other sizes available. Plus, there are also more typography settings for headings so you can get the exact look that you want. And there are improvements to the list view. Now, it's already pretty easy to change the order of blocks in your posts and pages, but what if you want to move it a long way up or down? Well, the list view has been improved to allow you to move blocks there as well. So from the editor, click the list view icon in the main toolbar. And here you'll see a list of all the blocks in your post and page. You can simply click on one of them and then click and drag it to the new position. And drop it wherever the line is. And WordPress continues to make the native social icons block better too. It's now easier to select the icon itself or the wrapper. Let's scroll down just a bit. And there are some exciting improvements to the gallery block. Now, all images within the gallery block can have all functions applied to them that you can do to the image block itself. So when you click on an image, you'll see that standard image block toolbar above it. So now you can add styles like duotone filters, links, and more to each image. Now, the entire gallery block has been refactored. So if you're using a plugin that has a gallery block that relies on the WordPress core code, and most do, then you'll want to check with that plugin vendor to ensure that they have updates to be compliant with the WordPress 5.9 code before you do the update. And there will also be a warning pop-up when you insert a new gallery block, and it states, if you want to edit the gallery you just added in the mobile app, to avoid losing any data, please make sure you use version 18.2 of the app or above. Also, block responsiveness has been improved. Now, some native WordPress blocks did not render themselves well for mobile display. WordPress 5.9 enhancements have made changes so that the internals of nested blocks reorder themselves for better layout on mobile screens. And many blocks now have flexible layout controls too. Let's scroll down a bit and see more changes. And I sure like this addition. There are more HTML anchors available on all blocks. Now the heading block has an anchor element. Let's click on this so you can see it. Clicking on that heading and over here in advanced, you can see down here for the HTML anchor, and it's already pre-filled. With this, you can easily add an anchor link, often called a jump link, to that section. And now WordPress 5.9 has added the same anchor element to all blocks so you can easily label and link to them. There have also been some reusable block bug fixes because some folks have complained that their reusable blocks would completely disappear. But in my opinion, reusable blocks are still too buggy to use since the 5.7 update, and I hope they completely change how they're saved in the first place. Another change is rich URL previews. You can now click on that link in the editor to see a preview of the site that it leads to. Now, I read that you should be able to hover over that link on a published page to see a preview of the destination site, but I could not get that to work, so maybe they'll change that. Let's scroll down just a little bit and see the next improvement for the Block Pattern Explorer. Now, I believe one of the reasons that reusable blocks have not gotten much attention from the WordPress devs is because their focus has been on block patterns. And given how wonderful block patterns are, I'm still stunned at how many designers are not jumping all over these things to make page templates for themes for things like landing pages and such. So WordPress continues to add more of them for us and make them easier to use. And hopefully someday designers will wake up to the fact that they can sell these things too. Now the interface has a few new improvements. So just click on the Block Add Tool and then go to Patterns. And you can scroll down and see more of them here. And then they're pretty easy just to click and drag over. So I'm going to grab this one and put it right where that blue line is. And now we have it. Let's close this up and go to our next improvement down here for speed. Because WordPress 5.9 has made several speed improvements to the core as well. The first is lazy load. Now, lazy load for images was introduced in WordPress 5.5, and lazy load for iframes was added in version 5.7. WordPress does this lazy loading the same way many browsers do it, but speed tests have shown that the way WordPress applied lazy load attribute was actually causing a Core Web Vitals issue with increasing the LCP time, or largest contentful paint load. So they've improved how lazy load is applied in 5.9, but you're still better off using the lazy load feature in your caching optimization plugin, which uses JavaScript and creates a placeholder image and is better for SEO too. And there's now active embeds for Pinterest. But the reason I'm including it in the speed section is because anything you add from third party like this and Instagram feeds will be a massive speed drag on your site. And that's a huge no-no in the days of Core Web Vitals being a ranking factor. There are also improvements for designers. First is the block style sheets and CSS loading. Now, theme styles have traditionally been held in a single CSS file, but that also meant that all styles for all blocks were enqueued in that file, even though every type of block was not being used on every post or page. And being such a big file, it could also potentially slow down page load time. In WordPress 5.9, only the styles needed for the blocks on that post or page will be loaded. It's worth noting that a good caching optimization plugin can take care of the theme CSS file load time. What really slows down a site are having too many CSS files from plugins and such. So, for those using WP Fastest Cache or WP Rocket already, you may not see this improvement. And I'll be testing to see if we need to generate critical CSS with these plugins after we update WordPress 5.9 too, and or if anything breaks because of this change. Now, theme developers can add additional style sheets on a per block basis, and these will only be loaded when that block is in use, which should also improve speed. And there are changes to the theme JSON file. Version 2 of theme JSON rolls in with WordPress 5.9. Version 1 will still work and will be transformed at runtime to the version 2 format. And there are hook changes. New hooks and functions have been added to WordPress 5.9 to help developers work with taxonomies and custom post types, and in just regular posts too. So if you're using any type of hook in your theme or plugins, you may want to check to ensure they are WordPress 5.9 compliant prior to updating. And there are new post types. WordPress 5.9 has included 4 new built-in post types that are related to full site editing. So be careful about using them on non-full site editing compliant themes. Let's scroll down just a bit for more changes, because there's new PHP 8.x support. Now, WordPress 5.8 was minimally compatible with PHP version 8.1, but the WordPress 5.9 release is fully compatible with all current versions of 8.x, including the current release of 8.2. However, not all hosts are offering PHP 8.2, as they do not consider it stable yet. And FYI, PHP is one of the main coding languages for WordPress themes and plugins and impacts both your speed and security. So you do need to be on at least the latest stable version. Now, at the time that WordPress 5.9 is released, PHP 7.4 is considered the stable default at most hosts. And I would consider sticking with that for a while longer, as many themes and plugins are not yet PHP 8.2 compliant, but likely will be later in 2022. There's also an update to jQuery 3. WordPress continues to update the jQuery coding library that the native code relies on. Now, the last time They made a major change to the jQuery support. A lot of sites broke. And WordPress did not come out with a plugin fix for it for nearly 2 weeks. And it wasn't until the next release or two before we could get rid of that plugin patch, as time had to be given to all theme and plugin devs to update their underlying code. Well, WordPress 5.9 has made updates to the jQuery 3 library, and we'll see if any plugins or themes break as more folks update to 5.9. And this is just one of the reasons I suggest that we wait a while before doing this update. My Blogaid News subscribers will be the first to know when I believe it's safe for most site owners to do this update, plus any special instructions and checks that we need to do. So be sure that you're subscribed. Now here are just a few more dev changes. A change has been made in WordPress 5.9 for the way it calls up post revisions, as they're using a new function for it, and there's also a new template tag. Okay, let's scroll down and see a few more of these changes. And here we go with the full site editing, because the huge change in WordPress 5.9 is the new site-wide styles feature. Now, if you are using a full site editing theme, then you will no longer style it in the customizer. Instead, you'll use this new styles feature. To access it, over in the top right, you should see like a half moon thing. Now, I don't have a full site editing theme in here, so we're not seeing it. And the new styles include typography and block styling. And you can save these styles as a template. Now, FYI, this is all part of the Global Styles project that aims to help you apply styles site-wide and borrow individual styles for special blocks or such, too. Let's scroll down a bit and see these blocks. Now, most of these blocks were introduced in WordPress 5.8, but in WordPress 5.9, they've been improved and/or new ones have been added. And those full site editing blocks include navigation, the template part, header, footer, post author, next post, previous post, post comments, term description, and archive title. Now, about that navigation block. The new full site editing navigation block can be a wee bit confusing, as it can be used in two ways. In the full site editing theme, it can be used as your main navigation, like the primary links bar you have in the heading of your theme. To access it, go over to Appearance and you'll see the new navigation link. But there is also a regular navigation block that can be used in your posts and pages and your sidebar too. Now, one use that WordPress suggests for it is as a table of contents inside a post or page. Ooh, I'd be careful of doing this with this block or even a plugin, as it's not good for SEO. And you can see more about why I say that is in my DIY SEO course. All right, I hope you've enjoyed this tour of the main improvements and changes in WordPress 5.9. Be sure to subscribe to the Blogaid YouTube channel and come on over and visit me at blogaid.net for more helpful tips and tutorials. And I'll see you online.